He's with us for the rest of the hour. Fritz Springmeier, we appreciate him joining us. And we had Tex Mars on earlier, Tarpley, Joel Skousen, Dr. Catherine Albrecht, George Norrie. We also had, of course, David Icke, who said hi to Fritz and his work. Darren McBreen is here with his reports that we've also been airing throughout the evening. And we've got a lot of others coming up, Jim Mars, Bob Chapman, Salente, as I mentioned. And we're going to premiere a Inside Skull and Bones with Charlotte Iserby, who first gave the intel to Anthony Sutton decades ago to expose it. Some breaking stuff coming up at 7 a.m. today. Don't forget, we're doing the fourth annual Money Bomb to fund hiring more reporters, more crew members, funding our operation, and getting equipment we dearly need. If you want to donate, be part of this Money Bomb, it's InfoWarsMoneyBomb.com or InfoWars.com. We have folks still answering the phones up there, 888-253-3139, 888-253-3139. We also have a lot of items being auctioned right now on eBay. We have a link to that at InfoWarsMoneyBomb.com. Like this bullhorn right here, the sledgehammer we used to break into the other side when we expanded the offices a year ago, and all of that available at InfoWarsMoneyBomb.com if you want to find out more and be part of that. Now we take you to Fritz Springmeier, researcher, author, West Point graduate, patriot, author, who is a political prisoner and is now free and has bravely come on the show, the radio once this week in the nightly news. He joins us now for the marathon 27-hour transmission. And Fritz, joining us via video connection, it's good to have you with us.
Good to be with you and all the listeners.
Well, there's a lot to talk about here, and I'm sorry we got our wires crossed. You thought you were on tomorrow, but here we are.
It's still Thursday here.
It's what?
It's still Thursday here.
It's still Thursday here. It's like 11:14 your time, right?
Yeah.
Fritz, look, you were saying what I want to cover. You know, I asked all the questions in the last two interviews. What do you think is most important? Let me give Fritz Springmeier the floor.
Wow. One of the most important issues is the mind control. And I would say as an extension of that, just a way that they can manipulate events. Since I came on to your show, and I'm not going to get into any specifics, but people around me have been manipulated and in a way to persecute me. Pretty amazing if you see how it all goes together. Years ago, I visited with a man who had, by chance, he wasn't supposed to have seen this, but anyway, he was allowed to see it, and the engineer that showed him didn't think that anyone would believe him if he did tell what had happened. Anyway, he was in front of one of the Beast computers, and you can talk to the Beast computer just like you and I are talking, and you could ask the computer about certain things or about anybody, and the computer would tell you about anybody. And then you could ask the computer what would be a plan to manipulate their life in a certain way. And the computer, knowing that individual better than we know ourselves, would come up with a plan. And he was amazed. He was floored. In fact, the whole thing was so devastating to him. He was like a basket case for about a year after he was shown the capabilities to what they're able to do. But it's been interesting to see what's happened since I was on your show. Reactions from both sides. And of course, you have a great set of listeners. And I got, I haven't even counted how many email responses. It's going to take me days to get caught up with all of them. But people need to know that things are manipulated far beyond their comprehension.
Well, I mean, you know, Fritz, I wanted to be careful in our interview to not get into areas that the feds have threatened you on. But I didn't know this when we called you up to get you on tonight. I don't want to get into specifics or whatever, get you in more trouble. But you're saying you're being harassed or pressured because you came on this week?
Yes, there was a reaction. Let's put it that way. Very interesting. I won't get into the specifics. Yeah. It's interesting. That's all I'll say. Yeah, so I think it's important for people to understand both the mind control and how they manipulate events. There was a Illuminati kingpin, and he said that the whole world's a stage. What we're seeing on the news is just staged events. And, you know, they're manipulating things in the Middle East. They're manipulating things here and there. And it's all being manipulated for a grand design. And I think that's important for people to understand, that these things aren't happening randomly. And one way that they can, one thing that helps people to understand the extent of the control is to begin to understand their totally undetectable total mind control.
Now Fritz, looking at mind control, obviously, the public is starting to wake up. There's a big awakening happening. Have the globalists foreseen this? Are the globalists happy about what's happening? How is their plan moving forward right now? And what would they like to set up if they could have their druthers? What would the world look like?
Okay, several questions there. One is I was hoping when I exposed the Illuminati's total mind control, with three books, and within those books were about 40 pages of the actual codes. And as you go on television and other places, even sitting in some of these churches, like what you were talking about the other night, these apostate churches, you're going to hear these code words said repeatedly. And I had hoped that, you know, exposing it all would mean that they would have to change their agenda, you know, sort of retool all of their codes and everything. Hasn't happened. They just kept on trucking. It was like that goes back to what we were talking about the other night, how they really don't think we're going to make any effect. Because they just kept on trucking. They didn't change their programming scripts. They didn't change their codes. They just kept on. It's been a surprise to me. As to what we see coming down the pike, well, one of the things, like I said, and you can get a picture of this in the novel Brave New World, is where they're going to control reproduction, and they're going to be, the state is going to be manufacturing people. They're going to reduce the population. And you might wonder why they could be so heartless as to wipe out most of us. Because these people don't perceive us as any different than an ant. You know, Alex, if you were walking on the street and you stepped on an ant or 10 ants, it wouldn't even cross your mind. And that's, you know, people that have been associated up at the top have said that that's their attitude. And indeed, you look at history and it's the truth. For 100 or 1,000 of us to die means no more to them than if they stepped on an ant. And so we're going to see drastic population reduction. And the United States, as a political entity, has been committed by law to encourage other countries to reduce their population. Now, I'm sure you're familiar with all of this. And you're
sure, State Department Memorandum 200 and others.
Exactly. You know, we see this, we see the the big boys, Rockefellers, Rothschilds, and their companies and industry polluting, and then they come along and set themselves up as if they're these great environmentalists. And you talked about that the other night when we were talking about these false environmentalists. And so we're going to continue to see this mock war to protect the environment. That's going to continue because they're able to manipulate so much. It's important to them to continue having several of these wars going on, the drug war, the war on pollution and so forth, because it gives them the right to come in and manipulate and control our lives. One of the things that they love to do is get us to ask them to do what they want to do. Most amazing, and I've sat here and watched over the last 20 years, it works. They begin a program, it's a step-by-step thing, and before you know it, the common people are begging them to do what they had in mind to do from the very beginning.
So that's the problem, reaction, solution.
Yeah, it all ties together, exactly. So, just, you know, people are wondering why would they bring in a one world religion, just another control thing, get rid of those that have a conscience, and use religion as a way of manipulation. You can already see this. You can already see the mainline denominations oftentimes use religion, other religions do it too, as a form of power and manipulation. And they'll just continue the process.
How are things, as I mentioned earlier, how are things going for the Illuminati right now?
In general, pretty good. They had a slight problem here a few years ago that they're now going to rectify with part of their plan. Their plan's going to fit in. Is going to help them very comfortably manage it. The problem that arose was that you had a lot of new wealth. And that kind of situation happens whenever you have new frontiers, you know, like in the gold rush days or in the railroad days. Well, with the computers, we've had new wealth come in. And the new wealth is committed to the system. They're people that are part of the system, you know. They may be assets of the CIA or NSA or whatnot or other things. But they're not as directly controlled by the Illuminati as their own members, even though these people are pro-system and they're not trying to buck the system. What we have is what's called a rubber band effect. When something is ordered or something is wanted by the Illuminati, it doesn't get done because we have thousands of very wealthy people that are not Illuminati, and they have a mind of their own. So when the system says we need to do this, we need to do that, the reaction doesn't go like they want it.
That's why they want to get rid of the middle class. That's why they want to centralize control. That's why they want total government surveillance, because they want instant robotic submission.
Right. That's why they're going to take the American dollar down, because the new wealth has their money in American dollars, where the old wealth, like the Rockefellers and the Rothschilds, DuPonts, they have had time over the years to build up the foundations, the tax-exempt foundations, to put their money into land, to diversify to a point around the world that if they collapse the American dollar, they're still going to have their power when it's all said and done.